Hello everyone, in this video I want to show you how to make a Pythagoras fractal tree using GeoGebra. The way we are going to construct this fractal tree is very simple. We will apply three geometric transformations: translation, rotation and a deletion. So for example, we start with the main square, then apply the translation, rotation and dilation to obtain the top left square, and we do the same to obtain the other square on the top right side. We repeat this process to the new shapes and so on. To build this in GeoGebra, we will need only three steps: create an initial geometric shape, create a tool with this shape, and finally iterate. To start, let's make our initial geometric shape. First, define a slider t from 0 to 1. This is going to allow me to control the motion of my Pythagoras fractal tree. Let's define now point A as 0,0 and point B as 1,0. Now we use the command polygon with arguments A, B and 4 to create a square. Oh, by the way, if you want to follow these steps, just type the commands shown on the left column in the input box. I'm using GeoGebra class 5, but if you're using GeoGebra 6, the input box will be also in the left column. Okay, now we are going to define the centroid of the square with name S as C0 using the command centroid. Define a point F over a semicircle from point D to C, the top corners of our square, using the command point. Notice that I use the second argument in the command point where I introduce the slider T, so I can move point F as you can see here. Now let's define the centroid of a square defined by the points F and C. We call it CR, and in a similar way we can create the centroid CL of the square defined by the points D and F on the left side. Now we define the length DL, which is the length of the side of the left square. The length DR is the length of the side of the right square, and the length of the original square that I named side. We can do this in different ways. Here I use the perimeter command divided by 4. We also need the angle defined by the points D, C and F on the left side, and the angle on the right side defined by the points D, C and F. These angles change, as you can see here, when I change the position of the point F with the slider. Here now we can use the commands translation, rotation and dilate. Define the square on the right side as SR. This is obtained first by dilation with respect of the centroid C0 with dilation factor DR divided by side. Second, we applied a rotation with respect the centroid C0 and the negative angle on the right side. Third, we applied the translation from the centroid C0 to the centroid CR on the right side. The square SL is defined in a similar way, but for the values on the left side. Finally, we define the list with name output, which contains the two squares that we just defined. And that's it, we obtained our initial geometric shape. This object will be the base of our construction using iteration. The next step is to create a new tool in GeoGebra. We click on the Tools menu, select Create New Tool. In the pop-up window, in the Output Objects tab, we select only the list with the name Output. In the Input Objects tab, first remove all the objects and then click on the list to select first the object S, the initial square, and the slider T. Click on Next, and now we can name our tool. I name it Grow, and I type in the Help option, select the square, then slider. This is how we should use the new tool. If you can see this message, it means that you have created a new tool and it will be available on the top menu. Perfect! Now we have our new tool so we can use it to iterate. The last step is to use iteration. For this, first we need a slider n from 1 to 10 with an increment of 1. Now we use the iteration list command with a couple of extra auxiliary commands. I made a video with more details about how this combination of commands works to create a list of iterated geometric objects. If you want to check it out, follow the link in the description. And that's all. Now you know how to make a Pythagoras fractal tree in GeoGebra. I hope you liked this video. Thank you for watching. See you next time.